On March 8, 2023, the alert level was raised at a volcano within the United States, which produced two voluminous flame collapse landslides, which destroyed much of an existing volcanic cone during its lifetime, and has also not erupted in more than 100 years. Although such a repeat landslide is, in my opinion, out of the question for the moment, the volcano I am talking about is in danger of possibly producing a volcanic eruption, as it is producing its most activity since it last erupted in 1914, although a new eruption is not guaranteed. This is occurring at the volcano known as Tanaga, which is the westernmost of two active volcanoes on Tanaga Island in the Aleutian Island chain. It has become the fifth volcano to be at a yellow alert level in Alaska at the same time, with the other volcanoes at this level currently being the massive caldera volcano Aniakchak, Trident Volcano in Katmai National Park, Semisapochtli with its large caldera, and Takawangha, which is on the same island Tanaga is. In addition to these five volcanoes, one volcano, aka Great Sitkin, is erupting in Alaska. A magmatic intrusion is ongoing underneath the Edgecumbe volcano northwest of Sitka on Khrushchev Island, and three volcanoes in Katmai National Park are producing an elevated rate of earthquakes. If you think this is a lot to keep track of, you are not alone. Thus, to help my audience understand the intensity of the volcanic unrest, in my opinion, at each of these nine volcanoes in Alaska which are not erupting but are showing signs of unrest, I have rated them on an opinion-based 0 to 10 volcanic unrest intensity scale. I am placing Tanaga in the middle of the pack in Alaska at a similar, albeit less intense, earthquake storm occurred approximately 18 years ago in 2005, which suggests that quake storms of a similar magnitude recur at about once every 15 or so years. This is in comparison to Trident, which probably has a magmatic intrusion ongoing underneath its edifice, and is much more likely to unexpectedly erupt than its counterparts, although each item on the aforementioned list could very well all end up not erupting. The Tanaga volcano is located in the far western section of the Aleutian Island chain, where it is 65 miles west of the city of Adak. Since Takawangha and Tanaga are both simultaneously at a raised alert level on the same island where their centers are a mere 5 miles apart, there might be some related igneous intrusion at depth. The earthquake swarm at the Takawangha volcano began on November 17th on the eastern section of the volcano at depths of 2 to 4 miles below sea level, and although it has waned slightly over time, it is still at a raised alert level for its 111th consecutive day. On the other hand, the earthquake swarm at Tanaga began on March 7, 2023 at 1:30 p.m. local time in Alaska, largely occurring at 2 to 8 miles depth underneath the center of the Tanaga volcanic cone. Over the next several hours, earthquake frequency slowly increased until at 8:45 p.m. 2 to 3 earthquakes were occurring every minute, the largest of which was a magnitude 2.5. In my opinion, this is probably occurring due to some form of a deep magmatic intrusion which is causing changes in the hydrothermal systems of two closely spaced volcanoes, causing groundwater to move and expand. Thus, while a magmatic eruption does not seem imminently likely, a possible phreatic eruption caused by the flashing of water to steam, building in pressure, and an eventual explosion occurring does seem possible, especially at Tanaga. As a brief overview, Tanaga is a volcanic complex with five separate peaks consisting of various volcanic cones and lava domes, which have been intermittently active during the 125,000-year lifespan of this volcano. Two large collapse scars are visible, which were generated by lateral eruptions 120,000 years ago that destroyed an ancestral volcanic cone, and 3,000 years ago which destroyed the Sajaka 1 volcanic cone. The Sajaka 2 volcanic cone was completely built by semi-frequent eruptions of about once a century since then via both blocky flows of basalt and andesite lava, hence its red and gray coloration. Recent eruptions have occurred at both the Sajaka 2 and Tanaga cones, and based on the current location of seismicity, if an eruption was to occur, it appears most likely to begin at the Tanaga cone. Although such an eruption would likely have an explosive component to it, the island the volcano is on is unpopulated, and, in my opinion, the only effect an eruption might bring to the city of Adak is a light dusting of ashfall. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Mario Negrovic for becoming a new patron on this channel's Patreon page.